We're now going to create some lights, so I've just sent off a live render to visualize this. So we have a node called Gaffer 3. If I hit tab in Gaffer 3 and place this in the node graph. So this is a super tool, just like the Importomatic that we saw in an earlier episode. You can jump into it by doing control middle mouse button click, and you can see its contents. So this node enables you to create your lights, your light rigs. You can control the light linking directly from here. So if I just jump over and hover over this and hit E. Now, I'll mainly be creating area lights, but there's a lot you can do using the Gaffer 3 node. So I'll go into more depth into some of its key features in a later episode. But for now, we will just right click over here and select add 3D light. Now, if you're using any other renderers, it will appear here. So if I toggle area light and call it key light, then you can see that this has created a new group inside my scene graph. So if I go down to my light, then it will appear in my 3D viewer. Now what you can do is in the sync selection, toggle down to in and out. So if I collapse this and click away and then select my light inside the Gaffer 3 node, it will automatically select it in my scene graph. So this can be like an easy way to access your lights. So if I hover over here and hit W, oops, that is not what I wanted. If I want to toggle my transform manipulators, there we go, and start moving it around. You can also hover over this center of interest. So if you toggle this, and a shortcut is also by hitting T, then you can change its center of interest. Now, what this will do is enable you to transform your lights in relative to that center of interest. So if you start moving it around to a position, and if you scale up your light, it will create a stronger but also softer light. So you can also increase its intensity. So I'm just going to go up to something like 20. This is a lot more than what I wanted. So if you want any harsher lights, then you can scale it down and increase its intensity. But I think I'm just going to leave this as is. Now, if you want your lights to be centered on a particular object, so let's say my mug, then you can toggle this enable aim constraint, and it will come up with these parameters. And if you middle mouse button drag your mug shape into the target path, it will snap your light to that object. So if I toggle back onto my center of interest tool, it will have been snapped to my 3D object. Now I'm going to go ahead and create another light. So what I can also do is duplicate this one and then call this fill light and then transform this over. Now I have positions for both lights, and you can also change your light's color directly by double clicking this icon of this color box over here, or you can go into the material and it will display all of its material parameters. So you can change its intensity, exposure, spread directly here. So I'm just going to change its color, make it a little bit warmer, and you can play around with this. Now I've just tweaked the values a little bit, so again, you can pick up the scene file to take a look. We will look at the Gaffer 3 node in more depth in a few episodes, so do stay tuned for that. So in the next part, we will add shaders to our remaining geometry.